Every journalist faces the same challenge. How do we bring our backgrounds and our viewpoints and our experiences to the stories that we tell and, at the same time, remain fair in our coverage of the day's events? As part of the Matter of Fact Listening Tour, we're examining the issue of bias. Today, we take a look at bias in the media, whether it's real or perceived. To discuss the issue, three prominent journalists, Maria Hinajosa, anchor and executive producer of Latino USA on National Public Radio, Luis Rios, the director of photography for the San Antonio Express News, and matter-of-fact correspondent Joie Chen. Thank you to all of you for joining me. Luis, may we begin with you? You've been doing your job as really a documentarian in a lot of ways, a photojournalist, for a long, long time, more than 40 years. Talk to me a little bit about your team that you send out into the field. Are they racially diverse? What kinds of conversations do you have with them about kind of their point of view as they're looking through their cameras?
The one conversation that I constantly have, even though we've been doing it for so many years, is to look at the viewfinder, tell me what they're looking at. It's strictly interpretive, obviously, and very subjective. In what we do with still photography. It's an incredibly powerful medium. And the one thing that I always preach, and I'm old enough to preach now to them, I'll tell them that it has to be truthful, it has to be responsible, and more importantly, it has to be fair. And in the heat of the moment, and in editing and in shooting, you have to still remember that your job is still to capture that one photo, that the two photos, the 10 photos that encapsulate the message that was going to go through people's minds the next day.
Maria, I want to talk to you for a minute about bias in journalists, because I felt often that as journalists of color, if you will, there was a sense that, well, you're going into the story and you're Latino, so you're gonna be biased. Or you're African-American, or you're Afro-Latino, you're gonna be biased. When the default was that the white journalists didn't have bias, that that was something that the journalists of color sort of had to overcome. How, was that something that you had to deal with, it, and how did you deal with it?
Oh my God, Soledad, it's the bane of my existence. I write in the book, Once I Was You, about this experience of being a budding journalist, the first Latina employed at NPR in the news division. And so my editor, a white man from the Midwest, said to me, "Oh, come on, Maria, we all know about your agenda." And I was like, "My agenda? What are you talking about?" And he said, "Oh, come on, we all know about your Latino agenda." And I was horrified, and thankfully, Soledad, I was on my toes that moment. And I said, "Well, but then that means that you have a white male agenda." And he said, "No, but it's not the same thing." And I said, "No, it is the same thing. I don't have an agenda, you don't have an agenda. I'm a journalist. Good Latino, bad Latino, whatever, you know, you're not gonna like approach a story like that. You're gonna approach a community with interest to report." Then I did say, "You know what, I do have an agenda. I want people to feel something with my reporting."
Joie Chen, building off of what Maria was talking about, often in newsrooms there's conversations about objective truth. And I'm not sure everybody understands what objective truth means. How did you deal with that definition of objective truth? What does it mean to you?
Young journalists are the ones who are sort of pushing this into the conversation, that they're questioning this myth of objectivity. We should have confronted this a long time ago, right? What is fair? What is full? What is full disclosure? What is stenography journalism? Maybe we should be looking at that, you know, just recording, well, he said this and he said that and he said this and he said that. Is that journalism? No, that's just stenography. And that is the thing that I think we have to fight against. Think beyond just recording a statement. If you're doing that, all you're doing is perpetuating the propaganda of one viewpoint or another. That's not journalism. It's understanding the context of things and being able to analyze it, to assess the factual accuracy, and then to be able to tell those stories.
To learn more about bias and its impact on our lives, go to matteroffact.tv and watch our special, The Hard Truth About Bias, which includes guests like Oscar winner John Ridley, comedian Trey Crowder, the former NBA player Atan Thomas, and journalist Jemele Hill. Plus, you can take a look at a social experience where total strangers meet to discuss confrontations that went viral.